Festus, I want to hear how the cow crossed the river. How'd you ever think of that?
Oh, fiddle, Miss Kitty, that there wasn't my idea. That there was my Grandpa Hog Hagen's idea.
Now, wait a minute, Festus. How'd your Grandpa Hagen get in this?
Well, you see, Matthew, the way it was is, Grandpa Hog Hagen was the onliest one of us Hagens that could read reading. And I recollect when I wasn't no bigger than a tater bug, Grandpa used to read us young'uns these here stories out of the Bible. And they was this here one story about this here feller in Egypt that was escaping from the fairies.
Wait a minute. Hold on. You mean the Pharaoh?
One of them fellers. And directly they come a-running up to this here great old big wide creek.
Wasn't a creek, it was a sea. The Red Sea.
Well, when this here Moses...
Name was Moses.
When he seen the sea, see... Well, he went to work and scrunched up his eyeballs, and he commenced to get the burn down on that, and directly, why, he balled up his fist like that. And then he flung him out sideways, and he said, "Open yourself up, waters."
And the waters parted, right?
Oh, of course they did, just like they wasn't even there at all in the first place.
Just a minute now, just a minute. Are you going to sit there and tell me that you went into some kind of a rooster dance and parted the waters of the Cimarron River?
Golly, Bill, no, Doc. Of course, I done a few little gee-jaws at the very beginning.
Well, what in thunder's all this silly story you're telling about then?
Well, when I seen that them there waters wasn't going to open up for me, and them fellers are nipping at my boot heels about to catch up with me, I seen this old heifer, and I just collared her and rode her right on through, don't you see?
This is the most ridiculous and inane story that I think that I have ever heard in my life. And Festus, why in thunder don't you learn to read so that when you want to tell something, you will have read it, and then you can get the facts and you can tell them straight?
Doc, I've told you 100 dozen times. When you start to read reading, how do you know that the feller that wrote the reading right? Just because some feller writes some reading, it don't mean that the feller that's sitting down to write the reading wrote the reading right. And if he wrote the reading...